Hello, my name is Dirk Techtmeier from Caterpillar Global Mining in Dortmund, Germany. I'm manager of the project management team and I would like to introduce you to our 6060 FS hydraulic mining shovel. This machine has an operating weight of round about 560 metric tons and is equipped with a 34 cubic meter bucket. It can handle a payload of 60 tons per bucket. It is designed to four-pass load 240 ton class trucks in exactly four passes. The 6060 FS is equipped with a tri-power kinematic system. The tri-power system itself is characterized by a rotating triangular rocker, which is connected via a stable rod to the superstructure. Bucket cylinders and also the boom cylinders are also connected to this rotatable triangular rocker. Tri-power has two main benefits, a kinematic and a kinetic function. The kinematic benefit is that when either crowding or lifting the bucket, it is automatically held in a parallel position without any correcting functions by the bucket cylinders. And at the top end position, it is not possible to curl the bucket back, so there is added safety. The second benefit of tri-power is that we can have smaller diameter boom cylinders. And if there is smaller diameter boom cylinders, we need less oil to lift them. So therefore, we can have faster movements. On this machine, all tracks are made of one-piece design casting. The track tensioning system has two different operating conditions. There is one with higher pressure when traveling the machine, and then there's one with lower pressure when the machine is digging. Safety is an important feature all over the world in every mining application. On the 6060, we have only 45 degree access ladders, and in the event of an emergency, the operator can escape via this egress ladder. This is the service arm of the excavator. You can fill up all the operating fluids down from the bottom, including diesel, gearbox oil, hydraulic oil, and grease. It is operated from the ladder, and while we are here, I also point out to the travel gearboxes. They are well protected, and there are inspection covers to open it up and have a look at the inside. Okay, so let's have a look upstairs. Let's have a look at the engine module. The 6060 FS has two diesel engines, 3512 of Caterpillar. They deliver a total output of 2240 kilowatt or 3000 horsepower. One is installed on either side. They are protected by special covers to prevent people getting burned. If it happens that there is only one engine running, the operator can still work with that unit. All functions are available to work as it would be with twin engine operation. The hydraulic tank is in the center of the machine. In front of it, there are various control valves. On the top, you will see the high pressure filters. The suction port of the tank is at the lower end. On each drivetrain, there are two main pumps, and they are responsible for the traveling and for all the attachment functions. The 6060 FS is MDG 15 and 41 compliant. This means that all the hydraulic hoses and electric wires are separated from each other. This is the oil cooling module. All Caterpillar hydraulic mining shovels have an independent oil cooling system. So this means there is even cooling capacity available when the engines are idling. There are dedicated pumps that continuously send the oil to the coolers also when the machine does not move physically. That means even if the excavator is waiting for the next truck to be loaded, there is cooling capacity available. There are four swing drives on the 6060 FS. And for commonality of parts, you will find them also on other models. In the center, we see the rotary distributor. This component is responsible for delivery of oil to the travel motors of the undercarriage. The main hydraulic valve block of the 6060 FS is located on the boom. Therefore, there is considerably more space on the superstructure and there is less hoses routing from the superstructure up to the attachment. The valve block is easily accessible. There is two walkways and there is also a tie-off cable in the center where you can hook on with your safety harness. Let's have a look at the other components. So here we find the exhaust system. Also the exhausts are covered to protect people from being burned. Here we find the air filters and this is the cooling water expansion tanks. They have a special cap that allows for pressure release. There is also a starter and battery isolator for maintenance works. There is another access to the center of the engine compartment. Also on the top deck is a central greasing system. There are two pumps. One is for the attachment pivot points and the slew ring, and the other one is for the undercarriage greasing system. Now let's take a look at the cap. So this is the operator control area. This is the so-called control tower, and this is the board control system. It provides the operator with all the operating data that is required for the operation. In this tower, we find further controls for the excavator. Here we find the start buttons for the engines, and here, for instance, we have the swim brakes and the travel brakes. The hand levers are part of the electronic over-hydraulic servo system, and the sensitiveness of these levers can be adjusted to personal operator preferences. The hand levers control the boom, stick and bucket. The swing function is also controlled by the hand levers. There is two pedals to control the tracks on the left and right hand side, and there is another pedal to control the bucket clam. Of course, also the 6060 is available in backhoe configuration, like the 6040. Thanks for joining us on our tour on the 6060 FS. For further information, please go to mining.cat.com.